hall. You can listen to the engine moaning out his one note song. You can think about the woman or the girl you knew the night before. But your thoughts will soon be wandering the way they always do when you're riding 16 hours and there's nothing much to do. And you don't feel much like riding, you just wish the trip was through. See, here I am on the road again. There I am up on the stage. Here I go playing star again. There I go, turn the page. Well, you walk into a restaurant, strung out from the road, and you feel the eyes upon you as you're shaking off the cold. You pretend.
Hi, this is Ken Kaplan from the New England Motorcycle Museum and Kaplan Cycles, and today I'm proud to be representing this 15th anniversary Fat Boy Special Edition Harley-Davidson. And to quote our sales manager Jason, as he sat at his desk and this bike rolled in here, he said, "This is the nicest looking motorcycle he's ever seen in our shop." It is absolutely beautiful. We've had a lot of nice Harleys and custom old bikes and of all brands come through, but this is just an absolutely stunning head turner. I think it speaks for itself, the quality of the bike and what you saw in the video. This is one of the most fully documented Harleys we've ever had through here. This is a one owner bike, very low miles. It's 8,000, check it out, 8,710 miles. One owner bike, like I said, fires up, fuel injected. Absolutely perfectly. It's just been gone through by the techs at Kaplan Cycles, which do the restorations for the New England Motorcycle Museum, front to back. Thousands of extras have been put on the bike. I'll give you a full rundown and everything, go over the receipts with you. Starting at the front of the bike, the entire front end was taken off the bike and completely chromed. The uppers, the mids, and the lowers are all, these are factory Harley-Davidson lowers. These are not aftermarket chromed ones. These are Harley-Davidson lowers. The factory headlamp is already been chromed from the factory, but the whole front end's been chromed on this bike. It's completely custom, including the axle covers. The wheels are very, very special. The wheels were taken apart, dismantled. The wheel bearings were removed, and it was sent out and powder coated to match the factory 15th anniversary paint job. The rims are normally chrome. These are powder coated silver, and there's a gold leaf paint in every single nut and bolt on this thing. This is a completely custom bike. We have every receipt, documented receipt. There's over $32,000 invested in the bike, It's extremely low miles. It's about as nice looking of a Harley as you're ever gonna see. The brand new wheel bearings were installed. The brand new Harley Davidson, top of the line. See, it's got about 2 miles on it. See, it's got the nipples on the tires. Brand new Harley Davidson white wall tires with the black letters. Just stunning. It has a chrome voltage regulator cover. The running boards are custom chrome running boards. It's got a full stage one kit on the engine, including a tuner, a custom Harley Davidson intake on the air cleaner. It's all opened up, so it breathes really good with a K&N style air cleaner. It's a stage one kit from Harley Davidson, and it's got a set of the Vanson Hines straight shots on there, which sound awesome, and they pull a lot of horsepower on the dyno. The engine's the factory chrome in the gray package. One of the trademarks of the Fat Boy is the gray of the special edition anniversary model. It's not only the 24 karat 15th anniversary badges, but also the gray oil tank, which is replica of the 1990. This is the factory custom Harley Davidson gunfighter solo saddle, and it also has the anniversary badge on the center panel. The bike has just been completely refreshed. It's got brand new tires on it. It has a brand new paint job on it. It's a $1,500 paint job. That's exactly the factory original color, but it's a much higher quality than the factory paint. And it's clear coated with a hand pinstriping on there. These are brand new NOS badges on here. These are over $400 for the badges. They're 24 karat gold. Bike, you know, it's a 10-year-old bike, so there's a couple little scratches in it. We wanted it perfect, and it is perfect. The rear fender is a brand new NOS Harley-Davidson fender. This is not a custom paint like the front. We actually had a new NOS fender installed on the bike, so we didn't see that it made any sense to paint that. But the front finish is absolutely gorgeous. There's over $2,000 tied up in the bike between the custom paint, pinstripe, and the 24 karat anniversary badges. The bike is slathered in chrome front to rear. The has a custom turn down license plate bracket. The rotors, front and rear, are polished rotors, Harley Davidson polished rotors with a chrome bolt mount kit, chrome axle covers, chrome swing arm cover. The rear wheel, again, is powder coated with the gold leaf paint inside there, and the gold plated air pressed air valves. Brand new Dunlop, Harley Davidson Dunlop tire on the rear. Going around the other side of the bike. This is a no excuses bike. This is a show bike. This is a bike you can roll up into a show, pull a trophy with. This is a brand new Harley Davidson custom derby cover, and this was also painted, hand painted with gold leaf. You can see that was hand painted, as was inside of the swing arm cover. It's got a chrome sprocket, a chrome Harley Davidson axle covers. It's got a chrome Harley Davidson lower and upper belt guard, and again, you see the custom powder coated to match paint. One of the reasons Jay said this is the nicest looking Harley he's ever seen is the combination, the way this is customized with all the chrome. Yet it's got the factory Harley Davidson paint scheme, and the wheels are powder coated to match, and it's got the gold leaf paint inside there, which goes very nicely with the gold leaf paint, factory pinstripe, and Harley Davidson logo on the shifter. That's a custom Harley Davidson item. Just everywhere you look, there's a $100 bill on this bike. I actually have, this bike is extremely well documented. I've got the original factory brochure here, FLSTF factory brochure, and I'll read it to you. It says, when we tell you we've got big news about the 15th anniversary edition Fat Boy motorcycle, you know it's got to be big, and it is. A full 100 cc's bigger. That's right, for the first time ever, and only for a short while, we're offering a stock motorcycle with a 1550 cc, 95 cubic inch engine. All this added power comes complements of a Screaming Eagle big bore kit. Get behind the controls of this upsized engine with super smooth electronic fuel injection, and you'll see it fits right in with the rest of the machine's girth. Huge forks, giant floorboards, mammoth light and nacelle, and the tank plissons is plated in 24 karat gold. The oil tank gets color treatment to match the engine, and it's easy to see there's a whole lot to love about this Fat Boy. But get in the new Badlander inspired seat, set the chrome wheels in motion, and you instantly realize life can't be lived any larger. Choose it in silver or black, but don't dawdle. This limited production mile gobbler is only available this model year. And this 15th anniversary edition came in two colors, black and silver. This is the commemorative silver edition, which was a clone of the 1990, the original Fat Boy. So I also pulled off the internet some more information from a cycle magazine printed in July of 2005. It says Harley-Davidson has commemorated anniversaries before with special edition models, but I don't recall in recent history a specific model that celebrated its own anniversary. The motor company alters that history with the FLS TFI Fat Boy 15th Anniversary Edition bike, because the first one was 1990. Other distinctive and unique features of the special edition Fat Boy include chrome-plated front end, a special winged 24-karat gold tank plaçon with 15 years in relief. You see it says 15 years right on the badge. In an oil tank, color matches the engine. The 15th anniversary cues complement the Fat Boy's traditional huge front forks, wide bars, large headlight and nacelle, and shotgun over-under shorty dual right-sized exhaust. The original Fat Boy was penned as a testament to Harley's burly traditional image, and it definitely hit the mark. It's been hitting the mark ever since, with modest evolutionary changes and enhancements and consistent appeal. The 15th anniversary edition Fat Boy in brilliant silver pearl. The air cleaner cover, the timer cover, and the ignition switch plate receive gold pinstriping, as do the console, tank, and front fender, all complementing the 24-karat gold-plated tank badge. And I want to add that we added on top of that the gold leaf painting on the rims, the gold leaf painting on the derby cover, the gold leaf painting on the axle, and swing arm covers, all hand done by one of our artists here at the museum, and the gold-plated air valves. So that was all added on top of everything else I mentioned. Base price for the 15th anniversary Fat Boy was $18,495, while the Harley-Davidson factory security system, which this bike has freight and emissions, bought the final total of $19,098. And then of course you add on tax, freight, crap, and everything else. Summary, climb aboard this special edition Harley, crank the 1550cc motor to life, shift into gear, ease off the clutch, and enjoy the ride. All Fat Boys feature a low upright seating position, and as a result are exceptionally well balanced. The 95-inch motor makes for a quick, smooth, and fun ride when the street cruising and twisting along a challenging back road. Bottom line, the 15th anniversary Fat Boy is a worthwhile collectible with its timeless styling and limited production. The standard issue Fat Boy that comes with a special gold tank badge, and a standard 1450cc motor and regular disc wheels, so the standard one doesn't have all these extras and upgrades that this bike had. This bike, like I just said, we did the whole chrome front end on it. We did the brand new tires. The forks were completely dismantled. New fresh oil and seals were put in the forks. New wheel bearings on the front. So everything's brand new on the front end. The tank was in front fender. I have a fresh custom $1,500 paint job on them. It glistens like brand new. Everything's beautiful. The levers, everything on the bike is impeccable. All of the bike, I have the service records. I have the 1,000 mile, the 2,500, and the 5,000 mile service receipts. We did the 7,500 mile service on the bike. It's got 8,710 miles. We just did that 7,500 mile service at 8,700 miles. That service includes changing the transmission fluid, changing the primary chain case fluid, changing the oil, putting a brand new oil filter on it, flushing the master cylinder and the front and rear brake cylinder, and putting brand new brake pads in it, and completely flushing all the fluids. We also put the brand new rotors front and rear, so you have basically brand new brakes, brand new tires, brand new rotors, new paint job. The bike is in absolutely stunning condition, and we just put thousands of dollars of chrome on this bike. So it's pretty much ready to rock and roll. It is ready to rock and roll. It also has a brand new battery in it, brand new Yuasa top of the line battery. So this bike needs nothing. Let me show you the paperwork I have on the bike. In addition to the factory brochure, I've got the original factory manual, the 2005 owner's manual, and you'll see there's never been touched with greasy hands. I have the original package. This is one of the most documented bikes we've ever had. I have every receipt for this bike ever. I've got the 2005 HOG membership manual, the Harley-Davidson insurance advisor card. Here's the title. Single owner bike, never been signed over to anybody else. I have the technical literature list. Also, this bike came with extended service plan contract. I've got the original factory dealer invoice to the original owner out the door. The bike was $21,723 plus optional equipment and accessories and sales tax. It came to $23,693. Again, $23,693. It's just under $24,000 out the door. Here's the odometer disclosure statement showing that it had no miles and was brand new. Here's the extended service plan receipt. I've got the 1,000 mile service receipt.
I've got the 2,500 mile service receipt. I've got the 5,000 mile service receipt. I have the digital fuel optimizer. That's the for the stage one kit. The chrome belt sprocket cover kit. The chrome belt guard receipt. I've got the clutch derby cover receipt. The sprocket cover and chrome hardware seat receipt. Softail chrome rear axle adjuster, oil filter, chrome rear master cylinder cover, chrome sprocket hardware cover kit, the payment on a special layaway voltage regulator chrome kit, rear lighting kit, just goes on and on and on. Just receipts out the yin yang, they just keep on going here. Every receipt ever done on the bike. Rear disc brake rotor screw chrome kit. Here's a receipt with the axle cover, the brake rotor polished, rear brake rotor, the front brake rotor, the pivot bolt cover, the chrome headlight head bolt cover kit. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. It's got the chrome head bolts on it too. The chrome rear axle, chrome brake rotor. It just goes on and on. There's $1,000 of bolt-on stuff right there. Here's the Harley Davidson 24th anniversary. Tank emblems, chrome floorboards, brand new brake rubber, pretty much everything. Here's a bunch of the front end chrome parts. All the receipts, fully documented. Take a walk around the bike, show them up close one more time. Again, the bike came to us with $26,934 worth of receipts. We put over $1,000 in parts, $540 in tires, $635 in chrome plating, $750 on the chrome Vance and Heinz straight shot exhaust, $100 for the chrome floorboards, $240 to powder coat for the rims and the derby cover, and the 24 karat gold leaf painting that was done to the bike, bringing the grand total investment on this bike to $32,186. I've got every receipt on this bike. I've got full documentation on this. This is a $32,000 custom anniversary special edition Fat Boy loaded with options and accessories. And I'll tell you, I took this to bike night over at Genworth's Harley Davidson, and it's a real head turner, man. It's a lot of people were coming up and asking about it, and I mean, it rides beautifully. Suspension is brand new on the front, and the rear's only got 8,000 miles, so the suspension is perfect. Rides super nice. Buyers right now. That don't bring a smile to your face, you might be dead. So if you want a badass Harley at a fraction of what it costs to build, buy this bike. If you want a limited edition, fully custom, low mile, special edition Fat Boy that you're not gonna see another one like it anywhere, buy this bike. If you want a bike that our sales manager said is the nicest motorcycle he's ever seen, this is the bike for you. And I'm sure it's gonna sell for a fraction of the $32,000 invested in the bike. I mean, the buy it now is going to be less than half of what's in the bike. That's just the nature of the business, but I can tell you, as an investment, this one's about bottomed out. They start going up at about this point. Once they're about 10 years old, they drop for about 10 years, and then they steady out. So you'll be able to get your money back out of it, and you're basically getting a brand new Fat Boy. If you have any questions about the bike, give us a call, 860-454-7024. If you want to come take a look at the bike, hear it run, have it demoed, whatever you want to do. We'll help arrange shipping. Hope it goes to a good home and someone really enjoys it. It's a fantastic bike. So good luck bidding on it, and God bless America.